And now we're going to learn the most important thing you'll ever learn in bookkeeping and accounting, and you will only learn it from this video. How to prove that your entire set of QuickBooks Online records are correct to the last detail. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. So how could we prove that everything in our QuickBooks Online records is correct to the last detail? Well, we know the bank reconciliation proves most things are correct, and you really should reconcile every company bank account and every company credit card account that you record in QuickBooks Online. Anything not proven by reconciliation can be proven correct by other steps shown here in this course. So why does BankRec prove most data is correct in all the rest of the accounts in QuickBooks Online? Well, we know that every transaction changes cash and another account. For example, if cash increases, usually there's an income account that's also increasing with it. And if cash decreases, then usually there's an expense account that records an increase for whatever reason decreased the bank account, like if we paid for delivery or if we paid for repair. So we know, if it's a strictly cash company, that every transaction changes cash and some other account in the chart of accounts. And the computer makes sure that everything is the same in both accounts. We only enter the transaction once, and the computer will record it in cash and the other account. And the computer makes sure that it's the same in both places. Therefore, if it's correct in the cash account, then it's correct in the other account. And if cash is correct, then everything else in the company's chart of accounts must be correct. But what about a non-cash company? Well, no matter what, you will always have some transactions that have to go through the bank account. And that's true even if we allow our customers to pay on credit. And even if our vendors allow us to pay on credit, ultimately, some things will still come through cash. And if we have accounts receivable and we have accounts payable, that means that every transaction changes either accounts receivable, accounts payable, or cash. Think about it. We're either paying with cash or paying with credit, and that's accounts payable. Customers either pay us into our bank account or promise to pay in the future, and that's accounts receivable. And since we have a computer and we enter only each transaction once, that means it must be the same in both places. Therefore, if the transaction is correct in either cash, accounts receivable, or accounts payable, then it's correct in the other account. And if these three accounts are correct, then everything else must be correct. Now, if that assertion is true, then all we have to do is reconcile our accounts receivable and our accounts payable, along with cash and credit cards, and then we will have proven that our entire set of books and records are correct. Well, guess what? We already learned how to reconcile accounts receivable and accounts payable earlier in this course. Remember, we learned about customer and vendor statements and fixing misapplied payments and so on. So if you follow those steps properly and reconcile the bank and credit card accounts, that's how we know that everything is correct. Now you may well ask, why is reconciliation the method of proof that we use to prove these accounts are correct? Well, that's because each transaction recorded in these accounts are compared to an independent source keeping records of the same events. For example, in the case of the cash account, the bank is the independent source keeping records of the very same transactions. In the case of accounts receivable, the customers are the independent source keeping records of the same transaction. And in the case of accounts payable, the vendors are the independent source, and it is in their best interest that they also keep accurate records of the very same transactions that we are recording. Therefore, if they agree with us, then our records must be correct. Now, there's lots and lots of data in each transaction that we record. And in our QuickBooks Online records, there's many, many transactions. So what are these reconciliations checking for anyway? Well, we already remember what the bank reconciliation does and does not prove. If the bank reconciliation works out for credit cards and bank accounts, it proves that all transactions are included and that none are missing. It proves there are no false transactions and no duplicates. In other words, there's nothing there that should not be there. It also proves that the money amounts of each transaction are correct, or at least it's correct enough to rely upon for your bookkeeping procedures. But what does vendor reconciliation prove? Well, it proves the bill amounts, dates, and bill numbers are all correct. It proves the bill payment amounts and dates are all correct. It proves bill payments have been applied to the correct bills. And it proves the total balance of the vendor is correct at the moment that we are reconciling. If you do not contact the vendor to correct something on the statement, it is assumed that it is correct. So then what does customer reconciliation prove? Well, it proves that the invoice dates, numbers, and amounts are correct. It also proves that the invoice payment amounts, dates, and transaction numbers are correct. It proves invoice payments have been applied to the correct invoices. And it proves the correct service items or merchandise is correctly listed on each invoice. And if the customer does not object in a timely manner to the statement you sent, then it is assumed that all of your accounts receivable is correct. But let's focus on point number 4 for a moment. If we have the correct service items or merchandise on the invoice, that means the customer did not object to the items that were clearly marked, and probably those items are correct. And we know that service items and merchandise are connected to an income type of account. We learned that earlier when we learned how to set up QuickBooks Online. Therefore, all income is recorded in the correct accounts if the correct items are listed on each invoice. So that's how we know if we reconcile with customers that our income accounts are correct. So what else remains that we can assume is correct because it's checked by an independent source? Well, payee and vendor names on check and expense transactions must be correct, or the vendor would not be able to cash the check or get the transfer. The dates on outstanding checks must be correct, or the vendor payee would object to the date that you put on the check. For example, if you put the date in the future, the vendor can't get the money. So if the vendor or the payee agree with the date, it is assumed it's correct. And items of service and merchandise listed on sales receipts must also be correct, or the customer would object to the price or the document details. These are all independent checks on transaction data, and we can assume they are correct because either the customer or the vendor would object. So we're almost there. We have almost covered every possible piece of data in a set of company records. There's one piece of data in transactions that could still be wrong that would not be detected by reconciling these three accounts in the way that we learned in this course. One piece of data in transactions that would not be checked by an independent source. Can you guess what it is? The answer is choosing the wrong expense or asset when recording a check or expense transaction. That field of data is the only one that's not checked by an independent source. Now, is that important to get correct? Well, it's important to the IRS because you have to make sure that you categorize your expenses correctly in your books in order for your taxes to be correct. Think about it. You must report the total of each expense category to the IRS when you do your taxes. It must be clear which expenses are deductible and which are not. Of course, the IRS knows that there is no independent check on the expense category. Think about it. The payee or the vendor for that check or that bill has no interest in what category this check or bill will be recorded in our own records. That won't affect them, and they would not be able to check that anyway. So what do we do? So stay tuned to the next video to see the techniques on how to address this particular point. And then you will know everything you need to prove that all your company's financial records in QuickBooks are correct to the last detail.